Hallo, hallo, Mike Test. Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the second video of our playlist on how to do backtesting in trading using Python for free. And in the last video, what we have covered is that we have made a data frame of 17,126 rows in which all the records actually represents to a 5-minute candle of Bitcoin. And after getting all this data from 12 data provider, we have put this engulfing column in the end, which will be referred to make this trading strategy. If you want to see how I get this data frame, you should watch my first video and then come back to watch this one. And if you want to know how to use 12 data and Talib library, then I have actually made some videos on 12 data and Talib library, and you should watch that videos, because those videos were specifically made for these topics and those were much in detail. In this one, actually I'll be just referring to the information that I provided in those videos, and I'll be very quick here. So if you wanted to make videos like this, or I would say playlists like this one, then just like this video. If it crosses 200 likes, then I'll make more playlists, such that you don't need to go anywhere to search. Everything will be in just one playlist. So just please like this video. Don't forget that I'll be referring to the code that I made for making that Bitcoin day trading bot, and because that was the strategy that I made, and right now I'm just backtesting that one only. And let's see if that strategy is a good strategy or it's a really bad strategy and it will lose a lot of money. So I don't know. So let's figure out. This is the trading bot that I actually made in that video. And by the way, this code is already present in my Google Drive, and how to get a free access of my Google Drive, which is actually the gift to all my subscribers. You'll very soon get to know what is it. So I'll be referring to this one. If you remember, in my last video, I explained that we are using core satellite strategy here, in which 80% is the core investment amount, and the remaining 20% will be actually remaining plus minus 20% is the active strategy, and that will be the trade amount that we'll be using actively. And so let me just copy and paste this. So paste it here. The amount is, as I mentioned, is 1000. The core trade amount is 80% of 1000. The core quantity is zero in the start. In the beginning, we have 0% investment in the core amount, and that's when we'll like make 80% investment after that. And the trade amount is 20%. The core to trade is true. If you remember, we'll change it to false after writing one condition. The portfolio value in the beginning, it's zero. We don't have any Bitcoin right now. Investment, real time portfolio value, closes, highs, lows, everything is an empty list. And money end is equal to amount in the beginning. So right now, money end, which is the amount which represents our trading amount, which we'll be using in future, is exactly 1000, because we have not yet started trading. I'll go here, and this is the paper trading simulator that we created in that video. If you want to refer to this paper trading simulator, I've made another separate video on how to create this paper trading simulator, and in that video actually I incorporated the transaction costs as well, so you can watch that video. But here I'm just referring to this two functions. I'll have to indent this a bit, so let's do it like this, and this two as well like this, and this one is like this. So briefly explaining what are this function is, basically I'm making buy and sell functions using some inputs, and then in the end we will have investment list, which will be actually increasing with all the transaction that we will be having, and the money end will also change, the portfolio will also change as we are buying or selling anything, I would say the Bitcoin in this trading bot. So similar to that one, in backtesting also I'm using the same paper trading simulator. Again, like, it's very very brief explanation. You should watch that video, the paper trading simulator video, to see like to learn it in detail. Perfect. So actually, in this data frame, the final DF data frame that we made in the last video, what I'm doing here is I am making one more column which will represent our portfolio value, right? And then we will refer to that column to do backtesting. That is actually the idea. So yeah, let's start with this one, final df. Let me just provide all the values to be zero for that. So it is equal to zero, and what should be the column name? It's like right rt port value. And if we check final df, so we can see that in the end we have all zeros in the final column. Now we'll have to replace all the zeros with the portfolio value. For that, I'll be referring to the code that we have written in the Bitcoin day trading bot. I'll very quickly, briefly explain what is this code. If you have written this code with me in my last videos, then you can skip this part. So in this code, what I'm doing here is I'm using WebSocket to extract the real-time Bitcoin prices, and then those real-time Bitcoin prices can be used to make this trading bot. If you don't know what is WebSocket is basically a two-way communication system in order to get the real-time data from the Binance platform. I've made a very detailed video on WebSocket, which is actually doing really good on YouTube, and you can watch that video to learn more about WebSocket. So yeah, using WebSocket, I have taken out all the data from the Binance API, which is actually this one. And then using this socket, I'm getting a 1 minute interval data. Right now we are referring to 5 minutes, but yeah, in this one we were getting 1 minute interval data. And then as far as this code is concerned, or I would say strategy is concerned, what we are doing here is first of all we are making our core trade, right, which is 80% of the money which has to be invested in Bitcoin at time is equal to zero. So at the time we start our Bitcoin trading bot, we should buy 80% of the Bitcoin at that moment only. So using the buy function, I'm actually buying the core trade amount, which is 80% of the portfolio. And then, this is basically the, the lines that I'm using to make the active strategy. So as far as the active strategy is concerned, we are referring to the engulfing, which is the same formula that we have written, if you remember. In this case also, file, I'm using abstract here, abstract API here. In that video, I didn't use abstract API. And we'll get the same number by using the same, by using directly Talib or using the abstract API. So after that, I was referring to the last value of engulfing, and on the basis of the last value of engulfing, we were making the trading amount, and then we were seeing how much money has been already invested in the active strategy. On the basis of that, we were checking what should be the trade amount for the active strategy, and then we were checking what is the real-time portfolio value, which is actually the value that we'll be referring to in this particular video for backtesting. And this will be the values that we'll be putting in the last column of real-time port value, this one. And then on the basis of the trade amount of active strategy, we were actually buying or selling Bitcoin, and then we actually ran the WebSocket. So this was very, very quick explanation of my 1 hour of video on Bitcoin day trading bot. You can refer to that video to learn it in detail. So I'll be referring to these lines to make our strategy here as well. So let me just copy this if core trade, and yeah, perfect. There's some problem if indentation, if we use Google Colab and Jupyter Notebook interchangeably for some reason. So we have to change the indentation. Yeah, if core trade, then buy core trade amount. Have we introduce the core trade amount is already there. Yeah, perfect. And the closest minus was, in this case we were having the closest list, which is actually this one. In this case, in our case, actually this is not closest, so this is actually final df and then close. I'm just referring to this one actually, and then close and then zero. So this is the price that I'm referring to, which will be used to buy the entire $800 of core investment. Let's move this line. Next line is core quantities will be increased by this amount. Again, this should be changed, replaced with this one. And then in the end, the core to trade should be false. Perfect. So now I'll take this one from here up to here. So let me just copy and paste it like this. Again, there's some problem of indentation. Perfect. Now actually, I'll have to write a for loop in which it will be actually referring to all the engulfing values. And then on the basis of all the individual engulfing values, we'll see whether we will have an investment in active strategy or not. Like depending on the value of engulfing to be 100 or minus 100 or 0 will make our decision of the active strategy. So I'll have to write a for loop here for let's see what is the size of this data frame. If we check it, the size, actual number of rows is this many. So for all these rows, for all this number of rows, I'll have to iterate using the for loop. So for I in range, I'll just copy and paste this one, and then let's indent this forward. Now I'll have to make some changes here as well. So the last engulfing in this case would be actually final df, and then this one, because I am referring to this one, and then I. So when I is equal to 0, I'm actually referring to the final df engulfing. Let me just copy and paste it here, and then 0. So I'll be referring to this 0, right? When I is equal to 1, it will be this one, and so on. So with different values of I in this for loop, we'll have different values of engulfing. Perfect. The amount is equal to last engulfing multiplied by trade amount. I think this will be exactly the same. We don't need to do any changes here. Port value is equal to portfolio minus core quantity into last price. Okay, so I think before that, we'll have to introduce last price as well. In this bot, the last price was introduced, I think, in the beginning only. Somewhere, I don't remember. Yeah, last price was here, so we'll have to introduce it here. No worries. So last price is equal to the final df close and then I think that's great. And then portfolio port value is equal to portfolio minus core quantity multiplied by last price. This is also great. Trade amount is equal to amount minus port value. If engulfing last engulfing is equal to 0, engulfing is already introduced, then the trade amount is 0, else trade amount is equal to trade amount. RT portfolio value is equal to money end plus portfolio multiplied by last price. And then let's just delete these two things. And in our case, here is the place where I can actually introduce this one. So final DF and RT port value is equal to this one and then I. So for RT, sorry, this will be a value and I think it should be I. Let's add it. So when I is equal to 0, then we will have the last engulfing to be this one. The last price would be this one. Perfect, because it's 0. And then RT portfolio value will be money and portfolio multiplied by this one. So this will be one value, right? And then RT port value I, which is when I is equal to 0, I'm referring to this one. When I is equal to 1, it will be this one and so on. We are just adding it like this. I think it's great. Again, let me just delete these print lines. When trade amount is greater than or equal to 0, then buy trade amount and then close is minus 1. It should be replaced with the last price. That's it. So let's see. This cell will take some time to run if I have not made any mistake. So let's see. So there's a mistake, unsupported. So this is in float format. It should be in string. Okay, so is it in float format? Let me check. Okay, so it's in string format. I'll have to change to the float format. Okay, so how to change the object to float? Let's see. Okay, so this is the one and I'll be using this one. pd.numeric. I think that's it. Final df, let's just check it. Close. Perfect. So it's in the float format. So let's run this now. There's no error. Let's see, it will take some time to run. So perfect. I think it's ready now. So let's see, we've got it. So final df, we have the last row to be RT port value, which is real-time portfolio value. And in the beginning, it started with 1000. This actually represents to both the money that has been invested and the money which is not invested, because in the beginning, we started with $800 of Bitcoin to invest, and then remaining 200 was not invested. So we can see that it started with 1000 and oh my God, it ended at 435. Have I made some mistake here? How is it possible? Oh guys, I forgot actually, I have covered the Bitcoin crash in this last 2 months. So like it started with 55,119 and it ended at 34,747. Okay, so the value of Bitcoin has gone down significantly, but our portfolio value has gone down even more. So let's see, to CSV, I'll have to do some Excel analysis now because I'm a bit confused now. So test.csv. So yeah, this is the data of the CSV file. This is our portfolio value, which has gone down from 1000 to 435. That's strange. And if we had invested 1000 in Bitcoin directly, then what would be the value? Let's see, 630. Okay, so the value of Bitcoin has gone down significantly and our strategy has made like more loss than the actual crash of Bitcoin. Actually, now it depends on the volatility as well, that like by how much amount our strategy has decreased the volatility. But still, there's a very big difference in last 2 months of my trading strategy and the buy and hold of Bitcoin. It means that my strategy really was not a good strategy. No worries, like that's why we do back testing. I would say I'm very happy now to know this thing, that the strategy was not that great. I'll have to work on more strategies to like try to beat my back testing results as well. But yeah, that's the main purpose of back testing, and you can see that in last 2 months we have lost significant amount of money using engulfing. So I'll come back to our code and let's see, let's plot our backtesting results. So import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and then actually I should keep it open like this. I should refer to these two actually. So yeah, this is the value for real time and this is the value for Bitcoin. I'll just save this and come back here. Actually, I'm referring to that file, which is the CSV file that I made, but we can actually make another column of the Bitcoin buy and hold strategy as well, which can be used for plotting. But right now, I would say I give this thing to you because the way that we have created this real-time portfolio value column, the similar way we can use to make the buy and hold strategy, in which we'll be investing $1,000 at time zero, and then eventually we can iterate it till the last row to see what is the result. But I'm actually referring to this one now, to the CSV that we created. So back is equal to pd dot read CSV test and then CSV. So let's see what is back, and in order to plot the graph, we just need to do plt.plot and then back and then RT portfolio value. Similar to this, I am interested in Bitcoin and then plt.show. So you can see that our portfolio, I would say our strategy has lost more money than Bitcoin. And actually for a very long time, they were just following each other. And then after that, the spread started increasing. You can see that in the end, our portfolio has lost more money than Bitcoin. So clearly our trading strategy sucked, but before saying that, there are more analysis. If you remember this slide, these are all the analysis that I'll be doing in my next video. So yeah, don't forget to watch that video as well. So we'll be talking about the return analysis, risk adjusted return, volatility, value at risk analysis, excess return, we'll make the confidence interval, and a very good thing is that we will be working on maximum drawdown analysis as well. I'll be talking about all these things in quite detail in my next video. So let's stop this video right now. Let me know if you know any particular trading strategy that I should cover, which will actually have a very good backtesting result as well. Just mention in the comment box and I will be really happy to cover that in my next videos. If you like my work, you can tip me and I'll be making playlists like this one in future as well. And I'll be providing more quality contents, more educational contents on YouTube for free. And your contribution means a lot to me. And the gift to all my subscribers, I share my Google Drive access with everyone. And in that Google Drive, I will be sharing this code. And there are many more codes present over there, including the Bitcoin trading bot that I made, and all the codes on the 12 data, the WebSocket, etc. And in order to get the free access of my Google Drive, you just need to subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on that access to my Google Drive button and just follow some steps over there. And on that Google form, you just need to provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. Click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there if you can see the backtesting analysis video, then it means that it has been already uploaded. Just go ahead and watch that one, and over there you can see how I created the Bitcoin trading bot that I was referring to this video. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.